One of my favorite sociology theories is called broken windows theory. It was originally coined in 1982 by James Wilson and George Kelling, and then became a popular theory, particularly in the 1990s. However, the theory most likely originates in some studies done in the 1960s by Stanford psychologist Philip Zimbardo. I enjoy this theory because of its unique perspective on crime, particularly property crime, and that it helps explain my own deviance as a youth. The idea of this theory is that when we see things that are broken down, we feel like no one cares about them, and thus we can further violate them without repercussion because obviously nobody is looking after it. Therefore, no one is going to care if we break it further. For example, if we came across a building or a car with broken windows, if we were interested in breaking windows, this could be a great opportunity because someone else has already started the process and nobody has taken care to clean it up. So we could do it as well without getting into trouble. Applying this to crime in general, then, crime is more likely in areas where there is less care, cleanliness, and orderliness. Crime then occurs more in neighborhoods or locations that are run down or uncared for, where the community cares less about its image. Hence, no need to keep up the good image. The damage is already done, right? The theory can also be applied to people. When someone is seen to be broken down, when it seems like nobody cares about them, they can be violated without trouble as well. In the 1990s, this theory was often applied to crime reduction and often reported with positive results. Okay, if this is the perspective on crime, then what policies do you think they or would you put in place to reduce crime in neighborhoods and communities?
Created using Powtoon.